In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Jesus told his disciples, "If any want to become my followers, let them deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For those who want to save their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake will find it." Once we were far off, but now in union with Christ Jesus, we have been brought near through the shedding of Christ's blood, for he is our peace. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, who in your tender love towards the human race sent your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, to take upon him our flesh and to suffer death upon the cross, grant that we may follow the example of his patience and humility, and also be made partakers of his resurrection, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever. Amen. Holy God, holy and strong, holy and immortal, have mercy upon us. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
A reading from the Gospel according to Mark. And they clothed him in a purple cloak, and after twisting some thorns into a crown, they put it on him. And they began saluting him, "Hail, King of the Jews!" They struck his head with a reed, spat upon him, and knelt down in homage to him.
What begins in tragedy ends in farce. He said he was a king, so dress him up as one, twist some thorns into a crown, and so that everyone can enjoy the joke, write it in three languages upon his cross: Jesus of Nazareth, King of the Jews. Then beats him with an inch of his life, the stupid dreamer. A king indeed. What a joke. Silence. The silence of horror. The silence of shame. I watch from a distance and can only think how glad I am it is not me, and how relieved I am that no one knows I follow him. My life does not display the marks of love. There are no distinguishing features that could cause offence or make others wonder whether love was real. Real, that is, beyond the love that holds us to ourselves and pulls down the shutters on the world. My drawbridge is up. My moat is full. My defences are at the ready. You won't catch me being so stupid as to love. Then they strip him, my king, the one who stands alone, the one who breaks down walls, the one whose agenda for my life requires that I stand naked too. I cannot bear to follow him, and I cannot bear to stop either. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, you face the torments of barbaric punishment and mocking tongue. Be with those who cry out in physical agony and emotional distress. You endured unbearable abuse. Be with those who face torture and mockery in our world today. To you, Jesus, the King crowned with thorns, be honour and glory with the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Holy God, holy and strong, holy and immortal, have mercy upon us.
Kingdom, in the words our Saviour taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Most merciful God, who by the death and resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, delivered and saved the world, grant that by faith in him who suffered on the cross, we may triumph in the power of his victory. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. May God bless us, that in us may be found love and humility, obedience and thanksgiving, discipline, gentleness, and peace.